In this topic, we're going to talk about NoSQL data storage mechanisms. And we're going to talk about the differences between what is NoSQL. Like, we'll kind of start off with defining what is NoSQL and how does that differ from a relational database that most of us are typically used to. And then we'll talk about some of the differences between the different service offerings we have in Azure for NoSQL type storage. The two primarily that we'll discuss are Azure Tables and Document DB, which is a relatively new service to Azure. But if we take a step back here and say, what are we talking about here with NoSQL? When we talk about a relational database, we're talking about SQL, Oracle, all these different types of relational database engines that exist on the market. And really what those are around are structured storage of data. So basically, we're able to define a schema, a common schema that we're going to define our tables, whatever objects exist inside of that relational database are going to be part of this, what we call a schema. Now that schema is static, right? So when we build tables, for instance, in a SQL database, we define what the columns are, what size, what length fields are, all these different pieces that define how we're going to store that data. And that's how these relational database engines really thrive on and are able to be heavily performant, because they understand our data. We can define things like indexes and those types of things. And really, indexes are around how can we best query that data? How can we get the data out fastest? How can we look up the keys fastest? How do we define all those kind of things? And again, around a big static infrastructure, it works really well. We've been using it for probably, 30, 40 years now. Mm-hmm. So great model to use. But it doesn't fill all the voids, right? So we had this notion of NoSQL databases come onto the market. And really what NoSQL is about is more about kind of semi-structured, I'll call it. So when you talk about storage, we're talking about full structured data would be something that I would say is a SQL database, a relational database. Semi-structured would fall into this NoSQL, and then at the clear other end of the spectrum would just be files, like in the blob storage would be just totally unstructured data. Mm-hmm. So if we take a look at that and say, well, how does an Azure table work? Well, if we looked at how it works behind the scenes, we actually define in Azure, so basically up here in Azure, we're going to define a namespace. We're going to define a name for our table. But in this table, we don't have the same kind of concept of a primary key to look things up, because we don't have a schema. To further describe that, we could say, okay, so up here we're going to have this thing called a partition key. I'll just say part key. And then we're going to have a row key. These two things, these two values, and they could be anything. These could be strings, ints, numbers, whatever. These are our keys that we're going to use. When we combine these two, it makes a unique element in our table. Now, when we store data up here in Azure, we can do it. We have SDKs for all the different libraries, whether you're using traditional ASP.NET or C#, all the way through Node and some of the different PHP flavors and things. But all of these things are coming through our service management API. These SDKs are just there to facilitate talking to it. So from a table perspective, when we store data, like the first time we could say, okay, we're going to store an element that has a first name, right? And then we're going to store his last name and maybe his email, right? And so that's we would store this, and maybe we say the first and last name are the partition and row keys, for instance. Maybe our partition key would be our last name, and the first name would be our partition key, or a row key, I'm sorry. So basically, when we define that, that's great. And then we could come along with the next thing that we want to store in that same table. Remember, we have a table name up here. But this time, instead of storing first name, last name, email, we would say first name, last name, and maybe eye color. And so what you see is we didn't put this one in. We didn't put email in. We didn't follow the schema. We just created a new schema on the fly. The only thing that had to remain consistent is these things, our partition key and row key, because that's the way we're going to query our data. Remember, that makes a unique key up. That's our primary key. Now, this infrastructure works really well. This is what's been built a lot of huge web services on the internet. Some of the big services out there on the internet are running NoSQL databases because it really scales. The downside of this approach is you can't do joins. So traditional, when we talk about relational databases, maybe we have our schema defined so that we have our users in one table, maybe some information about those users, like their address in another table, So we could have all these different things that are related, but we basically build these relationships between them in a relational database, hence the name relational database. In this, we don't have that relation concept. We can't do joins as well. These are really flat storage. So if we wanted to store the data differently, we would basically store it twice. So that's the way they get the speed out of these systems. So from a fundamental standpoint, that's what NoSQL is about. Now, DocumentDB puts a little bit of a more twist on it. So if we took a look at, again, back to what we were drawing out here, if we took a look at how's the DocumentDB differ from, say, a NoSQL Azure table? The thing about DocumentDB is they're stored in JSON files. And we mentioned JSON is the JavaScript Object Notation format, which is the common format that we've been using on the internet now for web services and template definitions and these kind of things.
It's much more lightweight.
Much more lightweight than something like XML
or SAML,
those kind of things. So basically, we define what we're going to store in here the same way that I just showed you with Azure tables. We define that in JSON syntax now. Now, the neat thing about this is we actually have some stuff running in Azure to store these documents that we call them. And these things are called documents, which would be your entities. But we basically store these things up here in Azure, and it has an engine that can parse these things, and we can actually create multiple indexes on these. So that's a kind of a key point here about the difference between picking between an Azure table and a DocumentDB. So an Azure table, we store the thing that we are making static is how we're going to query that data, and that's what our partition and row key is about. But when we're talking about a DocumentDB, we're talking about we can create our own indexes. So it kind of opens the door a little bit more to, we can use NoSQL in a couple more areas now because we get able to do query it in different ways and still get the performance that we're looking for from a NoSQL installation.
So I had a quick question when you were showing the two different types of keys. Is there a reason why or can I change those keys ever in the future?
So the question is, can you change the keys? So particularly like the partition key or those kind of things. Really, it's not possible, right? Because that's the way the storage engine behind the NoSQL implementation is actually going to write those things to disk. So when we store those, they're stored in such a way, and that's what the magic of these NoSQL engines is about, is how they optimize how that gets stored. Because we're saying, remember I mentioned last name would be it, because we probably have multiple people with the same last name in a partition. Yep. So that's the kind of things that designers are looking for when they're designing a NoSQL implementation, is saying, what are the common elements I want to query these by, or really how do I want to query these things? And so that feeds into, if you're using something like Azure storage tables, you have a little bit more flexibility with DocumentDB. And with that, I'll wrap up this topic on NoSQL implementations in Azure.